Another day, another night, another shitbird case. But what could a no good college PI expect on a no good college campus full of no good college punks?
Off it, Phil. I need you.
I heard that one before.
No, I need your help, Wise Alec. I'm serious.
Do things ever change?
With you, baby, that's a hard bet.
What kind of jam you in this time?
Something rather terrible's happened, and I just don't know what to do. I just don't know anybody else who deals with this sort of thing.
Terrible?
Disgusting, really.
Let's have it.
I was coming home after work last night.
Well, that's what they're calling it?
Shut up. I got home. I was real tired. I put all my stuff down, and I went into the washroom for a bath. But was stricken with horror when I saw the most vile mess of nastiness I've ever seen or heard of.
Mess?
It was horrible.
Out with it, girl.
Black gold. And that's when I knew I had to call you.
But you didn't call. You came. Boy, would I have loved to seen the look on your face.
Phil, how dare you?
Okay, I didn't mean to get you all worked up.
So you'll help me?
Yeah, I'll help.
Oh gosh, Phil. Thank you. Thank you so much.
You got it, kid. Now get on out of here.
What? Aren't you gonna come help me?
Really?
Yeah, really.
Look, you get over to one of your friends or something. I gotta get some things rolling, but I'll check it out. Don't worry. You stay somewhere safe. Somewhere loose.
Thanks, Phil. I'll be seeing ya.
Yeah, you will. Truth is, I could care less about going down to Lizard's place. To me, the whole thing's kind of funny, really. But that broad does something to me. And I don't just mean gnawing my heart like a rabid little gopher. Casa de Uris. Black and cold, but not nearly as black as the gold mine in a bathroom. Black gold for sure, and this one looks like it was struck by Jed Clampett himself. A real saucy mud pie, fresher than a Saudi hotbed. This was the work of a master. And when I see a masterful oil well like the gold plastered too thick to Liz's bin, I think of one name. Tony Grier. In my line of work, you see a lot of those types. Cheating, stinking, no good, tube-timing pedal pushers will sell you their kid and mother just to get ahead. To any crooked dick on campus, Greer's a whole different bag of beans. His handle really suits him.
On this campus,
if it's small-time crime, chances are Gruyere's got his hand in it. Rumor has it he's been peddling dope as of late. Fancies himself a real kingpin. No matter how many lips come a-flapping, though, I got nothing on the rat bastard. Sure, he stinks. He stinks like shit. But if that prick knows a thing, he knows how to keep his shit stink to a lull, as far as everyone else can smell.
Do corpo dourado do sol de Ipanema.
So I'm gonna have to do a little harder poop snooping if I'm gonna nail this slimy little toad.
Hey, Deuce.
Phil Lopian, you old scissor sister, you. How in the bloody shits are you?
Yeah, not bad, my man. How's business?
Business is business. Same old shit. How about yourself?
Actually, a whole new kind of shit. Literally.
Oh, jeez. Sounds funky.
You ain't kidding. I got a visit from Liz earlier.
How is the old bike?
Shitty. At least her apartment is.
Ain't that nice? How so?
Well, from the looks of it, someone left a rush of gold bigger than 49 in a bathtub.
Black gold?
From a real oilman.
Texas tea.
The finest. And now Liz is asking me to get involved.
Of course.
I'm kind of tied up in something right now. A heavy tail. Would you mind doing me a cool one?
Name it!
If you could just run over to her place and grab some samples and all that jazz, I'd really appreciate it.
You got it.
Thanks, Chief.
I'll call you.
Appreciate it, Deuce.
Anytime.
Well, that takes care of that. Now, where was I? Nice to see you, crust dick.
I didn't do nothing. I don't even know why the fuck you even here.
What, a guy can't enjoy some pool?
Not with me, he can't.
Don't worry. I'm sure I wouldn't be able to. You know, I ran into Liz earlier.
So what?
Oh, nothing. She's just worried sick about some crazy mystery intruder who snuck into her house at night and took a gigantic shit in the bathtub while she was gone.
Let me tell you something, Tom. You smell like one big gigantic shit, my friend.
I don't know what you're talking about, guy. I'm serious. Why would I shit in Liz's bathtub? You just don't go around saying this kind of shit. Fucking loony goony.
Don't get me started on loony goonies, pal.
I'm not your pal, anus hole.
I'm not the anus hole, Gruyere. You are. Yours is. And don't ask me why slimy fucks do slimy things. Look in your diary for that kind of shit. I'll be in Liz's bathtub digging through yours.
Serious, man. You gotta believe me. I didn't do anything, Lopi. I didn't do anything, Lopi. I didn't do a fucking thing.
Well, if I didn't do anything, I wouldn't have anything to worry about, Twinkie Tits.
Come on,
You're a real piece of fucking cock, Lopian. I hope you fall in the snow and get syphilis from a raccoon. You motherfucking greedy cock, sucker, Muslim fuck.
I'm very pleased after that little scuffle. And Tony boy is right where I'd like him. Cause I know quite a few things that make for a very unfortunate Mr. Gruyere. But it ain't enough. Not yet. I need a little something more. And when you need a little something more like this, you need to talk to someone. So I might have to go see the dirtiest, slimiest fucks you've ever met this side of the Mississippi. Not too bad in my book. How are you, Dickie?
To what do we owe this pleasure?
Pleasure, eh?
Well, you know how much we love the boys in blue. Especially you dicks.
Yeah, yeah. And although I love the flattery, I was kinda hoping I could ask you something.
Well, hope is a funny thing, Detective.
What do you all know about Tony Gruyere?
Ah, sniveling little prick.
See, now I'm starting to think that that's the only thing anybody knows about him.
No, no. That's just universally known. Lots of different people know lots of different things about Tony Gruyere.
Well, I see three fine young paisano gentlemen standing before me. Let's start with anything fun they might know.
Tony's all right.
Cut the cheese, Grater.
Fucks around. Didn't he may tell you that?
I do, though, Jackie Balls. Because contrary to the noises that just came out of your mouth, I don't know what Tony's doing. Not the real dirty stuff. I don't have anything I can pin on him. So why don't you help me out?
We ain't snitches, Phil.
He's right.
Well, you ain't no kind of friend of Gruyere's, are you?
It's not about
what it's about. Is me putting this cocksmear down. And I don't care what or who I gotta do in order to get that done. So why don't you start talking?
What do you got for him, Labes?
Detective Lopian, what a pleasant surprise.
The snack pack, kid.
Ah, Morton, right?
Right you are. Come in, come in. So glad you decided to come so soon.
Soon?
About the snack packs.
Oh, right, yeah. Are Chaz and Clyde here?
My housemates.
If you say so.
Oh, here for some questioning and such?
You betcha. Are they in?
But of course. I'll go get them for you. Oh, boys!
So it seems the two junkheads that
Dickie's boys turned me on to a Snack Pack's roommates. This might just get interesting.
Hello?
Hello, I'm Detective Phil Lopian.
I think I've heard of you, Mon.
Swell. Why don't we have a seat?
Is this about more stuff that he was worried about?
I'm sorry. Which one are you?
He's Clyde.
Thank you, Chaz. And, not really.
Not really?
About Morton.
No?
What do you guys know about Tony Gruyere? From that little tell, I'd say you guys know Tony on a base level.
What's that supposed to mean?
That does mean that you get your dope from him.
Why would you say something like that?
Hey, chicken ain't a duck, pal.
Huh?
Now, let's get back to Morty's snack packs.
His what?
Oh, you know his what.
Puddings?
That's right, puddings. Morton came to me about his constantly upturning snack packs.
So?
So? The kid has a year's supply of this shit that comes in like clockwork from his pep. And who, in their right mind, would jack pack after pack of snack? I'll tell you who. Two junkheads with no right minds.
Is everything all right?
Back in your room, Morton. And I will guarantee I can pin that on you too and have you packing your asses out of here so fast it'll make your head spin. Or stop spinning in your case. And when I say out of here, I don't mean back to mommy and daddy's in their scripts of OCs. I'm talking in the clink, behind bars, goodbye trim, hello Jim, bye-bye dope, dropping so.
Alright, alright.
All right. So let me tell you what I'm here to say. I don't give a fuck about that. And I don't give a fuck about you. All I give a fuck about is Tony Gruyere. So if you two tell me anything I want to know about him, I'll gladly let anything I know about you just walk on by. Come on, boys. You can pick your shit up from any of them other junkheads on campus. Do the right thing.
The right thing? You know what Tony would do if he found out we'd snitched on him?
Wrap our fucking heads in with a ratchet.
Oh, please.
Serious? I've seen him take the back of a hammer to Billy Bucks 2 front.
Ugh, that was Gruyere.
Damn right. Now Bucks is anything but.
Ain't that all the more reason to nail this prick? If we put Tony away, you won't have to worry about him. He'll be kaput.
Don't chive us, man. We know he'll have us pressed faster to the gas feed to a tank.
Yeah, don't jive us, man.
Well, what's so funny?
I don't know if it's the dope, or if you guys are just dopes. But you junkheads have got some serious fucking mural of Tony Gruyere painted behind your lid.
What the hell do you mean?
Well, I don't know where you guys get these ideas from, but Tony ain't got no muscle for pressing. He's a two-bit. He's nothing but a scrizzle weasel. Boy, oh boy, oh boy. Tony's not the one you need to worry about, boys. Started.
Okay.
Tony came to us a couple months ago.
Said he had a proposition.
And?
He told us that if we helped him out, he'd help us out. Big time.
And
we did.
So? Keep going, kid!
Snack packs!
Snack packs.
He wanted snack packs.
Jesus Christ, okay, so you started taking the snack packs from Morton to give to Gruyere
for his scheme. Enough with the one-note fucking answers!
Okay. Tony wanted the puddings to smuggle his bags in.
And to sell them.
He gives people puddings that ain't so suspicious.
Yeah, sure. Two grown men passing pudding cups back and forth. Real inconspicuous.
Hey, man. We didn't come up with the plan.
All Tony wanted from us was to get the pudding packs.
And then he'd give you your pudding packs in return.
I guess you could say that.
You see, fellas, that wasn't so bad now, was it?
Don't you need us to make a statement or something?
Course not. I recorded this entire thing. I appreciate the help, fellas. It looks like you might be needing to find yourselves a new benefactor. And, tell Morton it's all settled. I don't think you'll be needing Pep's puddings anymore. Be good, fellas. Liz, I had some news for her. She said to meet her here.
Phil?
Talk about somewhere loose.
Not bad, huh?
You ain't kidding.
So what kind of news you got? Good? Oh my, you know who it was, don't ya?
I do.
Oh, that's marvelous. What's the matter, Phil, honey?
I found it all out, Liz. Everything.
That's wonderful. That's why I want to give you a hug.
No, Liz. Everything.
But, what do you mean?
I mean, I know about Gruyere.
You do?
I have.
For how long?
A while. That's what makes this all the stranger.
What?
Well, I just found out Tony's been involved in, some dopey stuff. And things aren't looking so good for Tone.
How good's not good?
Going away good. And I ain't talking about no vacation.
I knew all that kingpin jive was no good for
well,
him.
Well, it wasn't just his peddling. Remember what I told you earlier?
About what?
About how I knew who soiled your plant can.
You mean that?
I'm saying that. Unfortunately for you, honey, Tony Gruyere's the one who took a shit in your bathtub. Toots. I don't think so.
Philly baby, you know that whole thing was nothing.
You're right. I know you are.
What? Was that some kind of fourth grade bash you just threw at me?
Well, fourth grade's a little young, but I wouldn't put it past you.
Fuck you, Phil. You're a real jerk, you know that?
Oh, I'm the jerk.
Whatever. You can act as self-righteous and perfect as you want, but I know the truth, Phil Lopian.
Can it, baby? I've heard it all before. Some things just don't ever change, Liz.
Some things?
Yeah, kid. Not as much as you'd hope, though. So here we are again. And I think this may have all worked out. Hello?
Hey, Phil. It's Deusmick.
Ah, Deuce. How are you?
Good, good. You know, I ran those samples you asked me to pick up.
Oh, Yiddy? And?
Well, that black gold in the tub, that was yours.
I figured you'd say something like that.
God's cock, I mean, I think this is when I ask if and why you had me go rifling through a bunch of your shit, Phil.
Well, Deuce, I had to play the card.
The card?
Yeah, the ruse. Cause something big just went down, Deuce. And you're the only other guy in the world who's gonna know it.
What are you saying to me?
Well, Deucey, I found out that Liz and Grier started bumping uglies a little while back. And that's right about where me and her started having problems.
I think I recall that.
Right. Because I knew she was screwing around and I didn't let her know it.
I know I recall that.
Right. And it was at that time that I devised the plan that just unfolded before us. Rather expertly, I'm happy to say.
So lay it on me.
Well, as you and I both know, Tony's got the crones and whatnot.
Of course.
And I knew he was up to some kind of drug junk and whatnot.
Of course.
So I figured I'd put two and two together and ring Liz into it in one fell swoop.
The black gold.
The black gold. I did the deed while Liz was out. And knowing that she wouldn't go to nobody else but me, I just had to wait until she stepped through that door. The only hard part was finding someone to rag on Grier. But once I did that, it all came together pretty nicely in the end.
Well, I gotta hand it to you, Phil. You are one sick son of a bitch.
Well, Deuce, you don't fuck with Phil Lopian.
Went down to St. James Infirmary, and I saw my baby there, stretched out on a long white table, so cold, so sweet, so fair. Let her go, God bless her, wherever she may be. She can look this wide world over, she'll never find another sweet man like me. I want you to bury me in Edmund Clapp's shoes, a box back suit and a Stetson hat. Put a $20 gold piece on my watch chain. So the boys will know I died standing pat.